Well, it's beginning of August and, you know, I've got elk season to look forward to.
Especially drawing that Kentucky elk tag.
Right, exactly. Lucky for sure. But obviously in the back of my mind, whitetail has been near and dear to my heart pretty much my entire life growing up in the Midwest here. So fortunate enough this year, we were actually lucky enough to get our hands on three of the new whitetail packs by Sitka Gear.
Sitka sent out, so they got three new packs. Again, the cargo box, which is gonna be the biggest pack they have available. You got the tool bucket, which is kind of a hybrid between the original packs they put out for the whitetail lineup. And last but not least, this is definitely a great addition, the tool belt. It's a little bit more designed toward that highly mobile, kind of a minimalist hunter. But each one of the packs has some different features, I feel, that really kind of cater toward a specific type of individual.
Right, everybody's a little bit different. I know myself, I carry a lot of extra gear, you know, stuff I probably don't need to. Those self-filmers or even the camera guy that carries a lot of extra batteries, your camera equipment and things like that, you're obviously gonna gravitate to the larger bags.
Yeah.
And I think the great thing though about what Sitka Gear does with their packs too though is we're all kind of similar in that sense, but even with the tool belt here, it's a smaller pack just to look at it. But as you'll see in just a minute, it's got some features. They really put a lot of thought into gear management and not just ability to store gear. So you can take a lot more into the woods with this pack than you would think initially. I'm kind of a little bit more of a highly mobile hunter. Part of that comes from a lack of ability to sit still and patience, I think they call it. But also I like getting out and checking out new ground. So this is definitely gonna be something that I'm gonna be carrying around in my arsenal this year. There's a few features that I really like. As I alluded to, this pack packs a lot bigger punch than what it initially looks like. You know, most guys are gonna see this and they're gonna think, well, it's just a smaller fanny pack, but especially when I'm climbing in and out of my trees and I'm hanging my sets, I like having these double pouches on the side. I typically carry a couple different linesman's belts with me. I feel like a lot of the trees we've got here in the Midwest, they're not just a straight pole, so you've always got branches and different obstacles to get around. Having the ability to quickly grab another linesman's belt, that's gonna be a big benefit. Another thing that I really like is they've got this two-way lid. So it's actually a magnetic clasp. It's got a little bungee adapter as well. But one of the things that I think is really cool about this, like any of the packs that you see nowadays, it's more and more common that you have a top load design pack. I like that if I am in a hurry, if I come across a deer as I'm walking in and out, I can get in here, I can maybe grab a rangefinder out or a release or whatever I need. But then the pack itself also opens up fully. And so like a lot of the Sitka Gear packs, you've got these nice mesh linings and you can actually see through those to see what gear you have in your packs. There's a lot of different storage compartments in here. Again, as I alluded to, you can carry a lot more gear in this thing than you would initially think. One of the big reasons for that, they've also got this pull-out mesh gear stowaway pack that actually has shoulder straps built into it. What this allows is, let's say that you do want to use this pack in a later season hunt, I really like the fact that I can throw some extra layers in here. Maybe I can even carry a pair of heavy pants, or I can carry a rain jacket, whatever the case is. I have the ability to put more gear in here, but then if I know for sure I'm not gonna want this pack, you have the ability to remove this so that you have additional capacity to carry different gear. So this is something that I'm definitely excited about. Again, a lot of great features. You can read up on this on Sitka Gear's website at sitkagear.com. Brett, I know you're a bigger guy, as you've kind of already talked about, you like carrying a lot more gear. So the tool bucket, cargo box, they're probably a little more up your alley. What do you think? What are you gonna run with this year?
Especially, I'm kind of undecided at the moment right now between the two. Honestly, if you're carrying a tree stand in, I'll probably gravitate towards the cargo box. It's kind of more feature built. It's got the bat wings, kind of help hold your sticks. It's an obvious year pack, kind of packs sandwiches between the back of the pack and the, you know, actually the bag of the pack, kind of sandwiches in there. So you can kind of carry everything together. And then also your camera arms kind of fit in here, bow hanger, things like that. A lot of the same features that are built into the tool belt are also built in the cargo box on the interior. You got your mesh liner with a bunch of zipper compartments and things like that to help carry your gear.
Yeah, and don't quote me on the number, but I think this has somewhere around 375 cargo pockets. It's not quite that many, but yeah, I mean, Sitka Gear did an awesome job. One of the things that I guess wasn't a complaint, but I didn't necessarily like about some of the older packs, the original tool bucket and toolbox, they had a couple just really big compartments, and inside of each of these I noticed they have a lot of small compartments so you can throw different accessories in, and it's all about accessories and keeping organized, which is great.
Yeah, I mean, carrying a bunch of batteries, wind checkers, you got everything you carry out into the woods.
Yep.
like I said, I'm guilty of carrying way too much out there. Plenty of pocket space in this thing to hold it all. And then kind of a step down from that is your tool bucket here. As Rich alluded to earlier, it's kind of a mix between the two whitetail packs that Sitka had before this year. Still your same, you know, open bucket type design. And actually inside this one, one little feature I'll point out to here, or point out to you, is I actually put a little Tupperware bucket in here, and this kind of adds some rigidity to the pack, and I can actually slide my camera inside the pack and carry it, and it's just a little bit more protected, you know, in case I step on that stump or that log is wet in the morning and slip and fall, so I don't break my camera.
This is a nice feature too. I like the fact that it's got this zippered section here that folds down, so you know when you've got your bag hanging up in your tree, usually you're fumbling around in here, and especially, I don't know how you are, I usually hang my pack a little higher than I am in the stand, so I feel like I'm always really standing up, reaching inside of the bag. Having the ability to get some of those extra pockets right there is a huge convenience as well.
And then, like Rich mentioned earlier also, I mean, just the added little compartments within here. Instead of two big pouches, now you have a bunch of little pouches that you're able to store, you know, smaller items, keep them a little more segregated, so you're able to find them a little easier in the woods.
And these packs are great too. So one of the things that Sitka did as well this year, they made these packs with a little bit more of a water resistant material. So if you're out and it's not a torrential downpour, you know, this pack's gonna be pretty good, especially with us. We're always carrying around camera gear. You don't want that stuff getting wet. But one of the nice things, Sitka also has this new reversible rain cover. This thing's great. It's pretty small, as you can see here. It folds up into its own compartment. This is better because you now can go from having a fairly water resistant pack to almost a completely waterproof and rain resistant pack. And again, it is reversible, so this thing's good for late season gun hunting, or if you just want to get out and keep your stuff dry. It's really nice, it's form fitting. This, I believe, on this will fit both the cargo box as well as the tool bucket. So. It's not necessarily going to be something you're going to be factoring out on this, but again, with this extra size, and it's very light, I mean, it's not something that you're going to really have be a huge encumbrance on you, but you're going to want to have a bigger pack to be carrying around with anyways. There's definitely a lot to be excited about with these packs, no doubt. But of course, we've just kind of scratched the surface on the different features and elements available for each one of these packs. We've recently written a blog article that kind of goes into a little bit more in-depth discussion around how each one of them can benefit you depending on your hunting style. So be sure to click on that link below in the description and you can read up on that detail.
And also down in the description, you'll find links to each one of these packs. That'll take you to the Sitka Gear website where you can order your own and have it ready for your hunt this fall.
Be sure to subscribe and click that notification bell so that you're informed every time that we post a new video. Don't miss out on any of the great cell phone news this year.